In our last videos on analog filters, we already got to know the world of passive filters. These filters, like their name already tells us, consist of passive components like capacitors or resistors, and they belong to the simplest filter circuits in electronics. If you haven't seen our previous videos on this topic, we recommend watching them first. You can find the corresponding links in the video description. In this video, we now turn our attention to a new world of filter circuits, active filters. Again, we can already conclude from the name that in addition to passive components, active components are also used in these circuits. In this video, we will discuss some simple active filter circuits as well as the advantages and disadvantages of using active components. Let's first start with some basics about active filters. I have already mentioned that active filters also contain active components. These can, for example, be transistors or operational amplifiers. In this video, we will deal with filter circuits that use operational amplifiers as active components, as single transistor active filters are very uncommon in electronics. Due to the fact that operational amplifiers have their own power supply, our active filters can use this additional energy to amplify signals in addition to filtering them. But more about that later. In one of our videos about operational amplifiers, we learned that they have a high input and low output impedance. This property brings us to the second big advantage of active filters. In one of our last videos on filters, we created a higher order filter by cascading several first order filters and ran into a problem, namely that the individual filter stages have an influence on each other. We solved the problem by increasing the input impedance of each stage. However, we have already briefly mentioned that there is a more elegant solution to this problem using operational amplifiers. Due to their high input and low output impedance, we can separate the individual stages from each other. More precisely, while the high input impedance ensures that the filter output is not overloaded, the low output impedance ensures that the cutoff frequency of the filter is not affected by the attached load. In this circuit, the voltage follower has a gain of 1. So this could definitely be better. So let's reconfigure the operational amplifier so that it has a gain greater than 1. If we want to set up the operational amplifier as the non-inverting amplifier, we simply add 2 more resistors to the circuit and we get a first-order active low-pass filter with gain. Let's look at the Bode plot to see how our circuit behaves now. We can see that frequencies below the cutoff frequency are amplified with the gain set by the 2 resistors. As soon as the cutoff frequency is reached, we see an attenuation of minus 20 dB per decade, as we would expect from a first-order filter. To simplify the circuit a bit more, we can combine the RC element and the non-inverting amplifier, which makes the circuit less sensitive to external impedances at its input. If we parallel the capacitor with the resistor of the feedback, this results in a very simple circuit diagram. However, we have to keep in mind that the operational amplifier has its own frequency behavior. At very high frequencies, we could reach the transit frequency of the amplifier, and thus our low pass would no longer work the way we want it to. But enough about low pass filters. Let's find out what active high pass filters or even active band pass filters look like. Again, we're basically doing nothing different than adding an operational amplifier to our familiar RC circuits. For the first order high pass filter, the gain increases with 20 dB per decade until the cutoff frequency is reached, above which we get our constant gain. Again, we can combine the RC element and the amplifier circuit by extending the inverting amplifier with a capacitor at the input. However, since operational amplifiers have a low pass behavior, the high pass behavior of our circuit will conflict at very high frequencies, and our active high pass filter will no longer work as expected. So always make sure that the highest frequency of the input signal does not exceed the bandwidth of the operational amplifier. At last, we want to discuss the active bandpass filter. In a very simple active bandpass filter, the operational amplifier is connected between the two RC elements. This means that the high-pass RC element is connected to the input of the amplifier stage and the low-pass RC element is connected to the output of the amplifier stage. In this configuration, however, we might run into the problem that our bandwidth is very large. If we want to build a more selective active bandpass filter, we can combine the individual circuit parts with the help of an inverting operational amplifier. This results in a circuit that contains familiar parts, namely the simplified active high-pass filter circuit and the simplified active low-pass filter circuit. The output of the filter is again taken over by the operational amplifier, and a narrower bandwidth can be achieved. In this video, we have learned about some first-order active filter circuits and discussed the advantages and disadvantages of these filters. We have also clarified what actually defines an active filter in general. In one of our next videos, we will dive further into the world of active filters and discuss, for example, how second-order active filters work. I'm Clara with the Institute of Electronics. I hope you have learned something today, but anyways, thanks for watching.